trying to settle down, we're never settling. I cut off all my hoes, I had to dead the flings. I pray I ain't Carmelo when I get a ring. I'm changing up my habits, doing better things.
I got a full video just to talk about Nipsey on the way, but I definitely wanted to start by paying tribute to him very quickly. And I also wanted to shout out Mac Miller once again, because I know ScHoolboy was very close with him, and that footage of Nip and Mac in the studio was also great. So rest in peace to Nipsey, rest in peace to Mac. We love y'all and we miss y'all. Let's get to the album. This is CrasH Talk by ScHoolboy Q. Number one, Gang Gang.
CrasH Talk, take one.
Oh, that sounded like K-Dot. What?
Been popping, hood ledger, chef boy, clean dope boy, whip clean dope boy, whip clean dope boy, whip clean dope boy, cheat codes, rock the car, love the keys, HBS rope weed, low life, real life, you ain't down the fool, no no dudes to be on pace to lose, me my dogs are what we about to do, me my dogs are we done brought the new, checkmate, all back.
Definitely feel like that was Kendrick that started off the song. You know, CrasH Talk, take one. Definitely sounded like Kendrick. And, you know, TDE is that roster, man. Like, y'all have a roster. Like, TDE is not to mess with, man. Number two, Tails. Come on, with a Q.
You all about it. Mopeds to dope heads. Who that N-word in that candy glove? Who that kid with no drive but at the park? You niggas tagging on walls, we spray the cars, D1, but like, I wasn't with it. My SATs and grades was high enough, but I wasn't with it. Bring my dogs with me, and cousins was on the thins all week. I think I'm finally recovered, and I tell you bye-bye.
Cool thing about that track, and, you know, I'm hoping that we get a little bit more of this, is I'm definitely feeling like, it's got that bounce that Oxymoron had with Gangsta being the intro. And that same energy that Habitat. And I like this from Q. I like when he really is, you know, focused with the tone of the sound. Like, that's why I loved Blankface so much, because I felt like the whole concept that he wanted for it, he just executed on every aspect. And, you know, I thought that was the best hip-hop project of that year when it dropped, only because it was just so pure and just such a testament to what ScHoolboy is great at and what he brings to the table for hip-hop. And, you know, this definitely off the bat is giving me Blankface vibes, but I liked how it's also reminding me of his other work too, but like, not in the sense to be like, oh, well, this don't sound like his old stuff, and oh, it's better than old stuff. Because, you know, everybody's gonna want another Oxymoron, or they're gonna want another track like Yeah Yeah or something. So, you know, I like that, you know, Q really took his time in crafting the album, but also it sounds like he really zoned in on what type of flow he wanted to do with certain sounds. So I'm excited. Two tracks in, I'm already loving it. Let's keep it going. Number three and number four, Chopsticks with Travis Scott and Num Num Juice. Now, these were the lead singles for the album. Num Num Juice was the first one, and then Chopsticks was the follow-up. I like both of these tracks. I like Chopsticks a little more. Num Num Juice took a couple listens for me at first, but again, I love this attitude that ScHoolboy has, especially with Num Num Juice. Chopsticks is already fire, but I like the new wave energy with it is cool with Num Num Juice. And, you know, I'm not the biggest fan of the new wave, but I like when people like ScHoolboy, people that can really, really spit, can take what these non-lyrical rappers are doing and turn it into something lyrical, but it still maintains the hype and it doesn't lose the value, if that makes sense. If you haven't heard Chopsticks or Num Num Juice, here's a little bit of both for you.
I gotta have you. Nigga, time's up. Got my coins up, my balls up. Soon we find them. We gon' slide them. We line them. Story kind them. Let it in. I win.
I mean, that's bitch shit. Thinking like you got it in your pocket. Yeah, that's bitch shit.
Number five, Drunk featuring Black. Ooh, this might be crazy.
I ain't really drunk.
Just a little buzz.
Definitely has a 90s feel to it. That's dope.
Never had enough past me. Going with too fast, ain't got
a liver full of yak weed in the bag. Got some rock for the hoes, chill, let me see.
Just a little buzz, just a little buzz.
Hey.
Don't you worry, baby, this on what I do. Backstroke, looking for a quick flood. And you already looking for love.
Yeah, for real, Black did his thing on that feature, and I really like that 90s feel, like that throwback vintage type of slow jam hip-hop, you know, not like LL Cool J's I Need Love, but kind of like Run the Streets by Tupac, like that's kind of what it made me think of, and I really like, you know, Black has been killing everything he touches lately, like, y'all, I mean, stop sleeping on Black, I'm gonna say that. But yeah, nah, I like that track a lot. Very, very chill, very vintage. It's dope. Number 6, Lies, featuring Ty Dolla $ign and YG. This, honestly, I said the last one was gonna be crazy, but I think this one might really be crazy.
Lies on me, that shit ain't okay.
Ooh.
Hey, hey, ooh. Hey, stop telling lies on me, that shit ain't okay.
Who the fuck said I ain't him? Got a new deposit, nigga, I ain't them.
Ooh.
Ran with the shit, never see no wins. I'm Lord A. Attitude at the old place. 488 year with the road rage. Nine on my lap, I ain't never blessed.
Hey, I know YG about to go off on this beat.
That shit ain't okay.
You said I hit it wrong, you lie. You said I ate them draws, you lie. Reaching for the stars, you trying. It's fuck, I'ma try to stop thinking with my dick head for once. Hey, I'm dick for the gal. She gonna be seen when you take her out. You fucked up my vibe.
Definitely know that one's gonna blow up. They're gonna do a video for that one. That video gonna be crazy. It's gonna be ratchet, but it's gonna be dope at the same time. Yeah, that's a banger. That one was just killing it the whole time. I mean, you know, that West Coast feel. See, this West Coast feel I'm not too tired of. It's the typical piano and the same beat that everybody else is doing. Like, it's very, very typical sound that a lot of LA-based people that make music use and have a go-to sound for. Like, nobody's doing stuff like She a Model or Aim Me, which were just, you know, classic YG tracks. But, yeah, it's I like this feel a lot more than, you know, every other song that was like Who Do You Love? You know, like that same pattern, and you know, the stuff like Blueface's I think the song was called Fuck 'em or Freak 'em or something like that, I don't know. But stuff like that, where it's just a couple piano notes and I don't know. Stuff like I'm Different. You know, when I'm Different came out, it was hot, but when everybody else started doing it, I wasn't really on it. So I like that this had that West Coast feel that I actually like really do like vibing with. Ty Dolla killed the hook as usual. ScHoolboy killed it, and YG does what he does best as usual. Number 7, 5200 or 5200. We'll see what they say on the record. Now that's definitely K-Dot. That's up there with the top so far. Love Lies, love Chopsticks, loved Gang Gang. The intro was crazy. Tails also went hard. You know, I haven't even gotten to the Kid Cudi feature and the 21 Savage feature, but 5200, that's a massive banger. That's crazy. Number 8, Black Folk. That's pretty crazy. Whoa.
Fuck up like I'm post to. Yeah. Who knew failure make you better? adversities determined to a killer. Was it somehow I lost it, the way I folded, the black minus where it started, cause we was chosen to buy the bread on the guap, on the fetty, on the bed. Get the fuck up out my face, what you say?
Wasted, wasted.
Bad bitch, you down with your down payment. All that damn hating, I'm better at love making. Trying to stay positive out of negative energy.
Now see, I wasn't expecting to get a real talk track after something like 5200. But y'all with all that hating, I'm bad at love making. Oh, okay, I see you, Q. That's crazy. That's crazy. Again, man, I think he's doing a really good job in spreading the vibe of the album. Definitely feels different than the last releases, but I'm happy with the structure of it so far. I think you got a little bit of everything so far. I'm interested to see where it goes next, though. I feel like now that we've passed the halfway mark, this is, you know, side B of the album. So let's keep going. Number 9, Floating, featuring 21 Savage.
Drip drop, sauce everywhere, ring got broccoli in my Ziploc.
That's crazy.
Bitch, I'm floating. Might turn into a ghost punk, bitch. Yes, I'm floating. Floating, I'm floating.
Yeah, money been here. The body's in here. I'm bringing up here.
Ooh, this has some wheezy vibes to it.
The pussy gon' wait. The money I chase. The robbery don't break. Can't don't. Yellow pills selling sales. And it's facts. I ain't trying to wipe you too emotional. My shit. Got a shoestring. Run a thing, dang. Man, who built like this? Okay, I'm floating.
We went from gutted to real proper.
Don't max, got no legs, bitch, I'm floating.
Like what?
He a broke for focus ass nigga. I'm so sure I got a chop. I just met a nigga, gonna call the cops. Can't bring the gang around rocks. Little nigga, do you got a problem?
What?
Little nigga, will come and stop it.
Okay.
Cash coming in, can't stop it.
Yo.
I'm running to the money, y'all jack the street codes, get punched just for trying to kiss me. 21, 21.
Floating, I'm floating.
Oh, That was crazy. Number 10, Dangerous, featuring the God himself, Kid Cudi. That's wild. Whoa.
I'm feeling dangerous. Running me crazy. Grip me by my hand till you teach me to flow. Head is in the cloud with my stomach below. How many friends around me helping me lose? How many excuses? Shadow my morning, I ain't bluffing and flying, I better escape.
Come on.
But flying ain't flying when you step on your ass. Pleasure took my driver, they called me to crash. The hell of a drug. Take this here, introduce you to love. Take this here, introduce you to love.
I'm feeling nauseous.
It's pretty cool to see the way that those clashing styles kind of blended there. I feel like ScHoolboy's main contribution to that collaboration was when the beat kicked in and, you know, he was just spitting and just really going in with that. And then that warped tone and, you know, the way that the melody was just all over the place, pretty much like a roller coaster. Like it was pretty much warped from start to finish, but it felt very different. It felt otherworldly, which is what Kid Cudi is. He's the man of the moon. So I like that. The give and take was there. Cudi had his part, and then ScHoolboy had his part. They both had something to bring to that song in particular, and it worked. I mean, I feel like that song has its own. Like, I feel like that song can be interpreted in a bunch of ways, and I feel like that song can be, I feel like that song can resonate with a lot of people in different ways too. Especially if you really like Kid Cudi and if you really like ScHoolboy. Like, I feel like that song would bring people together. Not only just for the sake of friendship, but I feel like, you know, y'all could both just show each other, you know, the greatness of Oxymoron and the greatness of Man on the Moon 2. Or Man on the Moon 1, whatever your preference is. I personally love Man on the Moon 2 more. That's just me. But that was a dope track. I liked it a lot. Number 11, Die With Him.
Got that 40 on my lap, I'm God, nigga. Hit that bitch from yesterday, she mine, nigga. Keep talking, bitch, then you can die with him.
Ooh.
White chalk on the ground, a squad, nitty. 1K with two clips, it came with.
drop it in my hoodie like a poster.
Now see, that's that attitude that was very present on stuff like Yeah Yeah, stuff like Man of the Year, even stuff like that part, like that has the same menacing feel. Like it's still very pertaining to Schoolboy's style, but it fits perfectly for right now, and it bangs hard enough that anybody could rock with it. Like it goes really crazy, but you know, the aggressive tone and the dominance that his vocals have, like he has such a presence when he raps, and that's why I think Blankface was so dope, because he really just went off from start to finish. So something like that I think is perfect for this album, and I think it holds true to what Schoolboy does. Like I feel like 151 Rum from DiCaprio 2 from Jid, I thought that was something that was very telling of how dope he really is. And I like that there's a bunch of tracks on here that Schoolboy has put on here to show that. But he's also, you know, trying different things, and he's also experimenting with other forms of, you know, expressing his talent. So I like that. And that track, definitely one of my favorites. I'm probably going to have a top five by the end of the video, but really good track. Coming up on the last bit of tracks, number 12, CrasH. This is an ASAP feel for real.
Fighting that case, I gotta find my way. Gotta need new shoes. If I lose, she lose. And I ain't getting used to losses. My feelings can't go blind by these women. Too many M's to make, too many rules to break. Family friends want a peace of mind. I can tell they all piecing up, and I can show them where peace resides. Since ages old, I knew a real rappers ain't impressive. Your tax bracket ain't impressive. You buy a chain, but won't buy no land. That hashtag should say desperate. I'm kicking game for these young niggas, cause what they'll tell me, my daughter. I'll be proud that your skin black, and be happy, girl, that your hair.
I ain't even gonna say nothing. He put it all out there. I mean, Cole tried to tell him, Hove tried to tell him. Now Q telling them, your little rappers ain't impressive. The hashtags say desperate. Wow. I Q. Now see, that's even crazier, because there's so much to that. All right, yeah. You thinking outside the box. I see. Number 13, Water featuring Lil Baby.
Y'all,
very new wave inspired, I can tell.
I'm so geeked up, I think that I'm Schoolboy. Make some rest, I'm a show about some new one. How the fuck did this bad nigga cross the border? Got a new bitch, I'm the West with the gang on that blue shit. They just talk like they told they don't do shit. When that white hit my hand, I'ma move it. So the 100 years, we just to prove it.
Yeah, it's pretty interesting that there's tracks like that on here on the album. And I mean, it's funny because it came right after the track where he's dissing a new wave or dissing these new lil rappers, however you want to go about it. But, you know, that's something that I want to touch on at the end of the album. So let's finish it up and then, you know, I'll give you my thoughts as usual. And finally, number 14, Attention.
Dreaming. Thing on my waist, been leaning. Yeah. Hustle for a job, they still ain't called back. I'm the best. Had a couple sessions with Dre, knew I would win. Alchemist, my favorite producer, and he my friend. All this love from the grace, put my passion in pen.
Come on.
Let me tell you about working hard through all our problems. The sun just couldn't be fixed. Got a pause and rest to sprinkle some orange in my blue shoes. Nigga ass traffic, baby dudes, yeah. And T2, thin but was normal, he came through. Nigga 51st and big on the corner. Mayhem was slaughtered months later like the shit ain't happened. I'm with my daughter at the laundromat. The shots rang off, I ducked to the back. Where it be? Dad on the gas, that gas my motor. Either grab the mic, nigga grab the same. I can easily tell my story now and climb from this moment. Imagine some of these rappers that ain't had you.
The godfather of the street shit that gave so filthy.
From Pac, Snoop, corrupt dads, big glide through the air, ain't cautious. Yeah. Mind on the ground, ain't dreaming.
That's a closer. That's how you close an album. Oh, shit. Yeah, he did that. Definitely did that. I have some comments, definitely, but... Oh, shout out. Between this and 2 Chainz, between this and 2 Chainz's album, it's been a couple good drops right hip-hop. Shout out Future's album as well. Alright, man. So after finishing CrasH Talk for the first time, like I said, I like that there's elements of the past work and how he goes about different sounds in hip-hop and how he varies what he brings to the table from track to track. I think this is the most creative album yet. And by that I mean there's so many different flows and there's different vibes with the music. But there's just so much more expression, I feel, in the way that the album is put together from start to finish. You know, I think because Oxymoron and Blank Face were both very theme-heavy albums, and they were both very centered on the vibe that ScHoolboy was in when he made them, and just, you know, what he wanted to prove to people, and, you know, being a part of TDE and being, you know, as lyrical as he is, it was cool to see him, one, having fun with the choices that he made on the album, but I like how he waited till the end of the album to really go off. He garnered your attention with, you know, tracks like Lies, tracks like Chopsticks, and, you know, he made you pay attention, and now that he has it, now he's going to show you what he can really do. I will say it is a lyrical step back from Blank Face, but that's to coincide, I think, with what TDE is doing. TDE is very smart. They know the game, and they know their audience. They know how times are moving right now, and they know that people are going to listen if it's catchy. They know that, you know, if the beat is hot, then they're good. You know, it doesn't really matter about bars anymore, which is crazy, but, you know, if you have something hot, a hot melody, a hot beat, a hot sample, whatever it may be, you're definitely guaranteed to have more people take a look at your stuff. And, you know, I said the same thing when J-Rock dropped Win. Like, he's not really rapping on that song. There's not much to say on there, but everybody knows that song, and everybody raps along to it. It's a big record for him. But the rest of the album is 10 times more lyrical than that song. I think by setting up the album with new wave sounding music, but staying true to how you and the rest of TDE move, I think is a great strategy, first and foremost. But it keeps that artist integrity that so many people lose after, you know, their second album. And this is his fifth. So, you know, to see him be creative, to see him have fun, and to see him express himself in multiple ways on this album is a very positive thing. And I support that. I hope he's doing okay, because I know the Max stuff affected him, and I know the Nipsey stuff affected him, as it has affected everybody else, but I really do hope he's doing okay, and he should be proud of this album. It's crazy. Shout out. That's going to do it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and like I said, the Nipsey video was on the way. Probably be up in a week or two, but I definitely wanted to start off with a tribute to him, but I definitely want to say more, because Nipsey deserves that first and foremost, but you know, that's just something else that I want to share my thoughts on. So, thank you for watching. Like, share, subscribe, the whole nine. You know the biz, you know what it is. It's Jared O'Brien. And I'm out.